Hey everyone, in this example video, we're going to be walking through a first-order divided difference example. We're asked to find the output of the following discrete data set for an input of x equals 2. If you missed our previous video on the theory and intuition behind the divided difference method, I recommend that you check out that video first. I will leave a link in the description down below for anyone that is interested. The first thing we need to do when solving this problem is determine what order Newton interpolating polynomial we will need to solve this problem. As we learned before, interpolating polynomials must always pass through every data point supplied to them. Therefore, our Newton polynomial will always be order of n minus 1. Therefore, in this problem, we are being asked to solve for a first order divided difference. A first order Newton's polynomial has the following general equation. As you can see, we are only missing these coefficients here, and these are called our divided differences, hence the name. But how do we find these coefficients for our Newton polynomial? Well, that is the magic of this method. We can simply use our divided difference table. To set up a divided difference table of the first order, we will create the column headers x, y, and then we'll just call it first order. Then, let's just translate our discrete data supplied to us in this table under x and y columns. Now, our first order divided difference is simply our difference in our y values divided by the difference in our x values. Now, for higher orders, this will get a bit more complicated, but we will talk about that in the coming example videos. So, to find our first order divided difference, we have y1 minus y0 over x1 minus x0. Which works out to be 5 over 3. Applying this newly found coefficient, and remembering that the divided difference of 0 is simply y0, we can go ahead and solve and simplify for our Newton interpolating polynomial. Which is 5 over 3x plus 4 over 3. You can now take a minute and try to validate your answer. We know that all of our x points must give our y points, as interpolating polynomials must pass through all our supplied data points. And in this case, we can see that we have done it correctly. Lastly, we are asked to solve for the output of our Newton polynomial for an input of 2. This results in an output of 4.66 repeating, and that is the answer to the question that we were initially asked. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to solve a first-order divided difference problem. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.